Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us see details on Sling reverse distribution in AEM. This is a continuation of earlier video on Sling distribution. In last video, we have seen details on Sling content distribution, distribution triggers, and forward distribution demo. In this video, let us continue with reverse distribution. What is reverse distribution? So a reverse distribution setup allows one to transfer content from a form of source instances, our case publishers, means multiple publishers, to a target instance, our case it is author. That is done by pulling the content from source instance into the target instance. So means author is going to pull the content from publishers. So if you see this diagram, target instance is author, then there is multiple source instances, 1 to n. Author is going to pull the content whenever there is a reverse content available in publishers. So these are all the configurations we should be enabling for reverse distribution. So first one is configure a queue agent and package exporter on publishers. That is a source instance. How many source instance you are going to have, or how many publishers you are going to have in the form? So you should be configuring a queue agent and package exporter on those publishers. Then you should be configuring a reverse agent on author, that is the target instance, pointing to the URL of the exporters on publish. So if you see here, this is the source instance 0, so means you can have multiple instance. So here two set of configuration, one is queue distribution agent factory, named it as a reverse. Then there is something called agent distribution package exporter factory, named it as reverse. Then we are linking this with this. So agent.target name equal to reverse. Then if you see the configuration target instance, that means author. So we are just configuring a reverse distribution agent factory. So name is reverse. You can provide whatever the name you want. Then this is the important configuration, package exporter.endpoints. So endpoint 0 is pointing to a publisher running on 4503. And the reverse, the name here is the agent distribution package exporter configured in publisher, same name we should be using here. You can configure multiple endpoints here, multiple publishers you can configure. So based on this configuration, whenever there is a replication or reverse content, author will pull that content based on this endpoint configuration. Now let's do a demo. So we are going to see how to configure reverse agent in author. So we can configure through either UI or OSJ config, then configuring a queue agent and exporter on publisher. Then we can enable a triggers, scheduled or JCR event based on our requirement, we can explain. We can test it. So testing, you can just use the curl command, or part of things can be tested through UI, or the triggers, whatever we are going to configure, that's going to automate reverse distribution. Okay, let's now start with configuration. So for that, I say first up, let me go to author. Yeah, so I will go to this is author. Okay, sorry. Yeah, this is author. I will go to AEM start.html, click on tools, go to deployment, distribution. What are the configuration we are doing it now? The same can be enabled through OSJ console also. I'm going with UI. Okay, there is some default forward agent is there. I'm going to create a new agent. Okay, I'm going to give a name reverse. Then agent type, you should be selecting reverse distribution. Then title, I will go with the same thing, enabled. Now service name, I'm leaving it to the default, but if you want, you can create a service user and service name and associated and configure here with the required access. Then log level, if you want, you can keep it to debug while configuring. Then endpoints, this is an important configuration. So let me take that endpoint from here. Yeah, this is going to be the endpoint because I have only one publisher, and I am going to configure the reverse. If you see here the reverse, So as I said earlier, this is going to be the agent configuration in name in public. So I will end it. You can add how many endpoints you want here. So I am going with one. So save it. Okay. Now if you see here, like status is passed, you should be resuming that. But before that, let me show you the configuration what got created here. Okay. If I search for this tree, yeah. So forward, yeah. Reverse agent agents factory. If you see here, there is a yeah, same thing whatever we configured. Some configuration can't be enabled through the UI, mainly this triggers I am not finding there, so we should be coming back here and configuring that. Anyway, we can do it better. Okay, the author side configuration is ready. So what I will do is I will go here and maybe we can enable this. So right now it's paused, so not easy. Click on this resume so that it will get it will resume it. Yeah, now it's a resume. That's fine. Now if I go here, click on that. Yeah, you can see it's enabled and idle. So means no items to process. So you can see the logs here, then settings, then here like you can't use the UI distribution here. Why? Because this is a reverse. It's only going to pull it. So you can't do anything from here. Yeah, now author is fine. Now let's go to publisher. Yeah, publisher, I will again go to the same thing, tools, deployment, then go to distribution. Okay, so click on create. Okay, again I am going to name it as reverse. That's fine. Select this option Q, title reverse enabled. Same thing with the service name. I'm not going to add anything here. Select this maybe debug. Allowed routes. So I'm just going and telling this content wretail. So you can add multiple routes here. So this is fine. Like click on save. Now if I go to this console, then let me refresh it. Let me search for distribution here. Yeah, if you see here, Q agents factory is created with the recording. Okay, the next configuration is agent based package exporter. So for that you can see the configuration here, Apache Sling distribution exporter, agent based package exporter. Click on that. So now enter a name. I'm going with again reverse. Then like you the target reference you should be referencing the target, the queue, whatever you configured earlier, name equal to reverse. Okay, this is fine. Click on save. Okay, now the required configurations are ready. So now we can test it. So what I'm going to do is maybe I will go to the publisher. So under this content vretail JCR content, I will just change the title to reverse. Okay, let me save this. Now I'm going to test with the curl command. So then later we can test through the triggers. So for that, like we should be executing two curl commands. So one is on the publisher first. So I modified some content. Now I need to add that content to a distribution. So here this is the command. So reverse is the agent name in publisher, then action equal to add, then path equal to JCR content, whatever the path. Now go to this and execute. Yeah, so if you see here, the success state equal to accepted, message queue. Now if you go back to this agent, let me open that agent. Yeah, so if you see here, there is a item pending for processing. So item is ready to be processed. Now author should be pulling that. So that is the way this reverse distribution is going to work. The content will be enabled in publisher, so we added that. So then author is going to pull that. So for that you should be executing this command, like on author. So there again this reverse is the agent name, action equal to pull. So now if I go here and again execute, yeah, so it's saying success, true, and state accepted, means it's the content could have distributed. Now if I go to author now, so right now the content the title is Yeah, we retail. Now if I just refresh, yeah, if you see, we retail reverse. So the whatever the content created or generated is reverse distributed to author. So author pulled that. Now another one, like we tested through curl comment. So if you want to do the same thing through UI, so publisher you can do through UI. So what you can do is, let me again enable some more change here. I will say UI, save this. Now go to this distribution agent. So now if you see here, distribute, okay, select add node. So then go to that path, like you say content slash b retail slash jcr. Now just to submit it. Okay, now enabled. Now if you see, there is a content ready for reverse distribution, but it won't get reflected here. So we are not pulled it. Author did not pull that. Now for that, if you go to distribution agent, distribute or whatever through UI, you can't test that scenario. So what I have to, you have to still do is, like, you go to this curl comment. Now I will execute this curl comment. It's going to pull it. Yeah, state accepted. If I go back again to the CRXT of author and refresh that, yeah, I got the updated content. Okay, now we will see the next step, like how to maybe automate this. Like right now we are like executing through curl comment or UI. So now let's see how to automate. So we should be enabling a triggers for that. Even we have seen some of the triggers in the last video, the part one. Here we are going to enable the trigger in two places. One is in publisher and another one is author. So publisher, what we are doing is, we are going to enable the JCR event trigger, so that whenever there is a change, so that change will get added into the distribution queue. So that is the first step. So then in author, we are going to have to configure a scheduled trigger, so that it will pull every, let's say, 30 seconds or 60 seconds. So the content will be reverse distributed to author. So even in publisher, you can use scheduled the trigger. Then you need to do the required configuration, because I will show you like what is the difference there. Okay, let's start with that. Maybe publisher we can start with. Search for trigger. Yeah, you can see here JCR event triggers factory. So I'm just going and saying maybe reverse sync, then path. I'm going and saying content slash b retail, then service name. Here the service name is mandatory. I'm going to use some existing service name, but in real scenario, create a service user and service name and enable the required permissions and use that name. But for now, I'm going and using the default. This is mandatory, otherwise this trigger won't get enabled. Okay, configure, then use deep distribution. So because I want any change under that path should be distributed, so I'm saying deep distribution. Copy this name also. So if you see here, this JCR event triggers factory trigger the distribution request for add and delete. If anything you add, anything delete, the corresponding distribution event will be triggered, either add or delete. So now I'm going and saving this. Okay, that's done. Like search for trigger. So if you want to use a scheduled triggers factory, you can use this same name. Then distribution type, you need to specify here as add. So because we are going to test, we are going to modify data, so it's a add. The distribution type should be add. Then you can specify the distribution path, what is the interval in second, and service name. Anyway, publisher, I am going with JCR. Now what you need to do is another one, like you need to connect this trigger to the agent. So for that, maybe let me distribution. So I will, this is the one, agent based, no, not the package executor, the agent. Yep, distribution agent, queue agent factory. Just click on that. Now if you come down here, there is an option to enable the triggers. Triggers name equal to, what are the name you copied, you paste it here. Yeah, reversing. Now save it. Okay, now the publisher configuration is ready. Now go to author, then again, like you need to create a trigger here. Trigger. Here I am going with scheduled trigger. So click on that. Now again I am giving the same name. Distribution type, here you need to say pull, because we are going to pull it. Now distribution path, again I am going to say content slash v retail. Interval in seconds, default is 30. So anyway, you can leave this. So again, the service name you need to specify here, the same one. You can define a different service name here and you use that. So save. Okay, the configuration is now ready. Now what I will do is I will go to publisher. So I will change some value here. Maybe I will say reverse trigger. Okay. Now let me save this. So the expectation is after 30 seconds. So if you go to this one now, yeah, so that changes here. Let's wait, maybe after 30 seconds the change should be coming and ending. Otherwise if there is any problem it won't. Let's see, not sure, it looks to be some problem. Oh, okay, I did a mistake here. So I need to go to this one, and again here also I need to link that to agent. So distribution, yeah, if you see here, yeah, reverse agent, go back to here and save that same name, reverse sync. Yeah, now that's fine. Let's wait for 30 seconds if that same changes are, if author is pulling the same change, otherwise we can do some modification. Yeah, the changes are now reflected. So whatever the changes we enabled there, through the JCR trigger, it added into the distribution queue in publisher. Then through the scheduled trigger in author, pulled that change to author instance. So like this, you can configure multiple publisher, and author can pull the changes from all those required publishers. Okay, this concludes the demo on reverse distribution. Maybe in the next video, we can see how to enable the distribution sync. Okay, thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.